So you want to be interesting. You want to have some sort of flair. You want to be attractive to people. You want to have something about you that people go, ooh. Well, you've came to the right place. So in this video, I'm going to take you through my 4 tips on how to become a more interesting human being. Now, first things first, I am not the most interesting human of all time. Yes, I have my faults. Yes, I can be boring. And some people don't even like these videos, which I know is a total shock. But the best way I've found, and tip number 1, in fact, is to use your voice. Use your range of expressions. Use your hands as well. You don't want to be someone that's just like, so, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, we are going to talk. Like, that doesn't work for people. People want some flair. They want some expression in the face. They want the voice to go up. They want it to go down. They want it to be deep. They want it to be impactful. They want it to be soft. They want some range of expression. You want to take someone through a journey of emotions when you talk to them, but you also don't want to just be this awkward person who just has his hands down by his sides and who talks like this and doesn't maintain eye contact or anything like that. You want to look them right in the face. You want to look them in the eye, not this creepy like stare in the face. I'm listening, But you want to be able to express yourself. You want to be able to come across genuine. You want to be able to show some range, because most people are so focused on what they say, but it's more important on how you say it. So if you can get that vocal range right, if you can be slightly sarcastic, if you can be slightly, you know, funny, maybe it's a little bit cheeky, or maybe you throw some accents in there or something, whatever it may be, context matters, obviously, so when you're in there, don't just start throwing out random Spanish accents. It's probably not going to go around too well. But you can see even in some of my videos, like I just did there where I lowered it just because it works. It works in the context of the video. So if you want to be more expressionful? Yeah. If you want to be more expressionful, whatever. Use your hands. Use your face to your advantage. Use your eyebrows. Put your eyes into it. Make sure you move your mouth. Don't just talk with your mouth closed like this. Move the full mouth. A great guy for this is Elliot Hulls. Now, I've talked about him a few times on this channel, but if you want to check out his videos, I'll put a link in the description below. But Elliot Hulls is great for moving his mouth like this. It's fantastic. It's quite mesmerizing, to be honest. But if you want to be interesting to other people, get that vocal range and put some effort into your face. So the second tip I have for you is to break rapport. Now, most people want rapport with people. Now, if you don't know what rapport is, it's basically the connection between you two. It's the getting along line. The rapport is good. You have good rapport with someone, you get along with them. But if you break rapport, it's a break in the chain, a break in the link. But it can make you a lot more interesting. So as an example, say you're talking to someone entirely new, you don't know them, but you get along really well. And maybe it's a potential partner, for example. Right? Maybe it's a potential, you know, person of the opposite sex, same sex, whatever. You are speaking to them, you're getting along well, you want to try flirting a little bit, you don't want to come on too strong. A way you can do this is to break rapport. Now, say for example, you ask them, you know, what's your favorite movie? And they're like, oh, I love, you know, the Terminator franchise or whatever. And you're like, really? Terminator? I'm not really a fan. And they're like, what? That is breaking rapport. Now, most people, if they want to impress someone, they go along and they say, oh yeah, Terminator was fucking amazing. It was fantastic, I loved it. And it doesn't do anything for the person. Yes, they may feel a little bit validated in their film choice, but if you want to be more interesting to them, you have to have that little edge, that little break off. Now, don't just go down the route and say that it's a full on shit film. It's terrible, they're a cunt for watching it. Don't go down that route. Just a slight break in rapport. Just a little ooh, just a little what? Make them shocked. Anything that raises an emotional response is good when breaking rapport. So this can be something like sarcasm, works really well. I don't know why I said it like that, but sarcasm works really well. And again, with the movie thing, it can be music as well. You can say like, oh, that band's a bit whack, isn't it? You think it's a bit 80s, you know what I mean? And they might just be like, what? No, it's fantastic. I love ABBA, I love Queen, something like that. Tip number 3 is to ask them some questions. Get them to open up about who they are, what they like, what their interests are, who they are as a person. Don't just ask, how are you? What job do you do? Do you like it there? Oh, cool. Don't just repeat back what they say. Ask some interesting questions. Things that you would want to be asked if you were wanting to open up to someone, if you wanted an interesting conversation. Don't just go for the generic stuff. It's too safe. You don't want to play it safe when you're trying to be interesting. So with these conversation tips, like, ask questions, but don't be creepy about it. Like I said, don't just start asking about random family members, what their grandma's maiden name was. Don't start asking stuff like that. Just get them to open up. Get them to be comfortable, to enjoy the interaction. It's not an interview. It's not an interrogation either. You just want to ask them some nice questions, get them to open up, get them to feel more comfortable with you, because that's how you build a relationship with someone. That's what makes someone go, wow, that person actually gave a shit about me. That person is interesting because they were interested in me. So ask some questions. Don't be afraid to maybe push the button a little bit, but use your best judgment when you're asking these questions. And the final tip I have for you is to go out there and actually live an interesting life. If you want to have stories to tell, if you want to be interesting to people, if you want people to come into your life and stay in your life, start living an interesting life. Go travel. Go do something really cool as a hobby. Do something that makes you an interesting person. Don't just sit on your ass. Don't just binge watch Netflix. Don't have a boring job. Do things you actually love, and it will shine through in your personality. You will show people that you aren't a boring stick in the mud, or whatever the expression is, right? You are not boring, you have an interesting life. Whether you're a martial arts expert, whether you make YouTube videos, whether you're a hardcore gamer, but you're, you know, MLG competing stuff, right? Whatever it is, as long as you love it, and you can maybe even show it off a little bit. If you go on my Instagram as well, you can see that I've documented a lot of my travels. I've documented a lot of places I've been, a lot of things that I've done. I like to show people that, you know, I have an interesting life. Not out of an ego thing, but being a coach, you kind of have to show people that, you know, this is how you can live. It's not that difficult to do. Like, if you wanted to travel, people say, oh, I can't travel, it's all money. You don't have to stay in fancy hotels. You don't have to stay in the best resorts. You can literally stay in a hostel and sleep in a McDonald's if you have to, right? A lot of people don't realize this, but if you go to a 24-hour McDonald's and buy something on the menu, you can stay there all night. You can actually pass out for a bit. They might wake you up and kick you out, but you still get some sleep. I know that's not perfect for everyone and a little bit of a side tangent, but it's doable. And again, this is another tip as well. I'll give you tip number 5 straight off the bat, is go on little side tangents. Go on little side tangents like I just did, like sleeping at McDonald's has little relevance to living an interesting life. But then you bring it back to the main context. Things like that will give you that little edge that you want in conversation, that little bit of more interesting flair when it comes to talking to other people. Now, most people think living an interesting life means they have to go jet skiing every other day with celebrities, they have to live the Kim Kardashian life, but they don't. You can have a very interesting life just doing your thing, doing your hobbies, doing things that you actually care about, and living a life that you can go, you know what, this is fucking awesome. I love this. It's no good trying to show off, because if you don't love it, people will notice. People will notice if you do not love what you do. So be very careful where you go with this path, but do your best to try and live an interesting life. Get out the house, take some pictures, take some videos, start doing something interesting, meet interesting people, network, go out and do things that actually interest you, and I promise you, people will find you way, way more interesting. So that's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you got some valuable tips out of it. If you did enjoy it, please leave a like, share, subscribe, all that jazz, and follow all the social media links in the description below. For more content, you can also head over to my website at www.adamproadspeaker.com for more videos, content, and testimonials, and to book me as your personal coach. Now, thank you very much for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next video. Peace.